A drone attack on a Syrian military academy kills at least 60 people. The weaponized drones targeted a graduation ceremony attended by the cadets and their families, Syria's defense ministry said in a statement. Terrorist groups had used drones to carry out the attack. A Syrian security source notes, Syria's defense minister was present in the ceremony, but left minutes before the incident. At least 51 killed, including a six-year-old boy, as Russia attacks a village in northeastern Ukraine. Russian forces targeted a cafe and a shop in the Kharkiv region. It was the deadliest attack in the area since Russia invaded Ukraine in February last year. It also appears to be one of the highest civilian death tolls in a single Russian strike. Ukrainian President Volodymyr Zelensky condemned Russia's attack, saying it was deliberate and not a blind strike. U.S. President Joe Biden says he can't stop federal funds from being used to build sections of a U.S.-Mexico border wall. He says Congress appropriated the money, and he's been trying to convince lawmakers to reallocate the funds. The move is a shift for Biden, who campaigned against the policy embraced by former U.S. President Donald Trump. The construction would build barriers and roads in a part of Texas that has seen large numbers of migrants crossing from Mexico.
You pledged not to build another foot of border wall. What changed?
I'll answer one question on the border wall. The border wall, the money was appropriated for the border wall. I tried to get them to reappropriate, to redirect that money. They didn't. They wouldn't. And in the meantime, there's nothing under the law other than they have to use the money for what it was appropriated. I can't stop that.
Do you believe the border wall works?
No.
Mexican President Andrés Manuel López Obrador rejects the plan, calling it a step backwards. López Obrador will soon meet with senior U.S. officials for talks focusing on immigration and security. Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our Bureau Chief, DJ Manoto.
Good morning, Nikki. Here are the top stories making the headlines amongst the Filipino community.
Kaiser, Kaiser, you're no good.
Treat your patients like you should.
Kaiser, Kaiser.
We begin with some 75,000 Kaiser workers from different states going on a three-day strike on Wednesday, with many of them in California. This is said to be the largest medical worker strike in U.S. labor history.
We're fighting for fair wages.
And our benefits.
Yes.
And our benefits.
So Kaiser needs to stop being greedy.
Filipinos who joined the strike say on top of fighting for pay increases, they are protesting the hospital giant's alleged efforts to cut their health benefits.
We have a benefit, but they're trying to get rid of the benefits.
They're also calling for an increase in staffing.
We're being understaffed, overworked.
Way understaffed.
Understaffed.
How hard is it to be understaffed for you?
It's very stressful.
Very mentally stressful for us.
Yes, for us and for our patients.
For their part, Kaiser claims they have been making progress at the bargaining table with the unions.
Do hereby proclaim October 21st, 2023, Mabuhay Park Day in Edmonton, Alberta's capital city.
We go to Edmonton, where the first ever Filipino park in Alberta, Canada was finally opened to the public. The celebration at Mabuhay Park showcased Filipino culture, food and products, and that signature Bayanihan spirit.
We have there Dr. Jose Rizal Monument that has been designated by the National Historical Commission of the Philippines as a Philippine historical site. So that is our first landmark, and Mabuhay Park is now our second landmark here in the province of Alberta. So we'd like to invite our members of the Filipino community to visit both landmarks whenever there are Filipino events taking place in these landmarks.
The Mabuhay Park, which is a gift from the city of Edmonton, recognizes the contributions of some 81,000 Filipino residents.
You know, community's going to appreciate the park. They're going to understand just how much our community appreciates the Filipino community, how much we love them and care for them.
And finally, we head to the Hollywood premiere of Star Cinema's new thriller, A Very Good Girl, the very first movie from the Philippines to premiere in Hollywood in such grand fashion. Its lead stars, Catherine Bernardo and Dolly De Leon, are ecstatic with the warm response from the audience, including critics and journalists.
Seeing them all here cheering for us, supporting the movie, it means a lot to me talaga.
It feels great. I really feel the love.
Film stars also came out to support the history-making Hollywood premiere.
ABS, if you're watching this, put me in your next movie. And to answer your question, yes, I am the next star.
It's October, Filipino-American
Justice is expensive, my dear, and poor people can't afford it.
A Very Good Girl will hit select theaters in North America on October 6th.
And those are the news making headlines amongst the Filipino community. You can catch more of our TFC News on our website, news.abs-cbn.com/TFC News, on the ABS-CBN News YouTube channel, and on the ABS-CBN News app on your smartphones and tablets. Back to Nikki for the rundown.
Now, over in Taiwan, one person was killed while more than 300 more were injured due to Typhoon Koinu. The storm swept through the southern tip of Taiwan Thursday, bringing torrential rains and strong winds. Thousands are still without power. Koinu, a Category 4 typhoon, made landfall in Taiwan's Kaohsiung Peninsula early Thursday morning. It's forecast to weaken as it heads towards the Chinese province of Guangdong. Now, in China, authorities in coastal provinces are on high alert as they brace for the typhoon. Some ferry services in Fujian have also been suspended.